I am absolutely blown away by the mock draft Todd McShay just updated. Man, dude, we're about to be happy as fuck. What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to a brand new episode of The Lead. Your host is always Harley Dugan. Todd McShay has updated an NFL mock draft. And look, this was supposed to happen a few days ago, but then that Bears-Panthers trade just threw a whole monkey wrench into the video I had recorded. So I had to delete it. But then Todd McShay said, "Don't worry about it, Harley. Don't worry. I got your back." And most definitely, boys, we're about to react to the latest updated Bears-Panthers trade included mock draft for Todd McShay, okay? So here we go. We all know who Todd McShay is. And again, mock draft originally posted on March 7th. The one I had reacted to, I had to delete. And now updated following the Panthers-Bears trade involving top 10 picks. This is going to be absolute mayhem. The draft, the chaos, everything seems to be going crazy right now. Do the Panthers keep number one? Do they move down? How does this affect the Texans? I don't think it affects us in any way, shape, or form. If anything, actually benefits us. But I'll get into that in a whole other separate video. But with that being said, let's get into it, guys. Carolina, as we know, made a massive trade package to the Bears to get to number one. Okay, so who do they pick? Who do the Carolina Panthers pick at number one? Boom. Done. Bryce Young, Alabama quarterback, the guy that most Texans fans want, including myself, is Bryce Young. I really want Bryce Young. I really do. I just believe the dude is special, and I believe everything he has overcame and implemented into this offense. He's very good at football too. And Bryce Young did amazing things at Alabama, even with lack of talent this year at the wide receiver position. I'm extremely not upset at this, because I do say that any of the top three quarterbacks, especially Bryce Young or CJ Stroud, should have tremendous amount of success within Bobby Slowik's offense that is the branch of the Shanahan Kubiak system. But BY off the board at number one. Now he said he's heard a little buzz about Anthony Richardson from Florida coming off the board at number one. If however true that is, we won't know. But man, that would be a shock to me that they traded up all the way to number one to get Anthony Richardson. Okay, so here it comes, boys. The number two pick in the draft. Who does Todd McShay get? Here we go. CJ Stroud is the next quarterback of the Houston Texans. And that right there solves, boop, checkbox mark off number one. Quarterback is the biggest issue for the Texans. As you see right here, we had the league's worst QBR last season at a 26. Okay, 41 touchdowns, had a massive game against Georgia. What really sells me, though, is not the game at Georgia. His combine, his arm talent, we saw a lot of things that answered for me in terms of CJ Stroud and him being the second overall pick and him actually being top two quarterback. There was some debate around CJ Stroud, but with not only the Georgia game, but his performance at the combine really transcended his talent overall for me. Again, I'm not mad against it whatsoever. I am happy that CJ Stroud is the quarterback. I will roll with it. And again, the success of this system is implemented across the NFL. So CJ Stroud getting into this system, 6'3", big body quarterback, pretty much a prototypical size for you. I'm happy with it. I am definitely happy with this. Number three, we got Will Anderson. Now it's time to move into the 12th pick. Who do the Texans take at 12th pick? We all know wide receiver is the move, it seems like, at number 12. Anthony Richardson to the Colts. Again, Shane Steichen's worked with some guys, some projects. Maybe it works out. Maybe it doesn't. That's a huge swing and a huge miss if it does not work out. Tyree Wilson, one of my top DNs, going to Seattle here. So, yeah, they lose a lot of guys. Hey, that would be a great addition. But Houston Texans state of mind, let's get into this. Raiders get Will Levis, Nolan Smith in the top 10. Wow. That's a huge, huge boost for them. Okay, Peter Skoronski. All righty, we got 10. The Eagles, woo-wee. That's a luxury pick in getting Bijan Robinson. A little bit of a hurt there. Okay, Titans got Paris Johnson Jr. Okay, boys, here we go. Here we go. We got the number 12th pick in the draft. Who do the Houston Texans take, according to Todd McShay? Yeah! Holy smokes.
Oh my God! Come!
Holy smokes. You know, I'm looking at these players. It didn't even dawn on me that Jalen Carter was still available at 12. I'm telling you right now, this might be one of the best mock drafts for the Houston Texans. And if this does come to fruition, this might be a damn good. Oh, man. This might be one of the best drafts for the Texans. And just day one, you're getting C.J. Stroud and Jalen Carter. Jalen Carter arguably being the best defensive prospect in this draft. And you get him at 12? You're telling me the worst? Oh, man.
Stand up now and face the sun. Won't hide my tail or turn and run. It's time to do what must be done. Be a king when kingdom comes. Well, you can tell everybody.
The worst Texans defensive line that we've ever seen, ever. Worst. The absolute worst. And they added Jalen Carter to this team, who can do everything for you, who is an absolute unit in the front, and D'Amico Ryans, Matt Burke, all of that defensive line, the build of the 49ers defense is through the D-line, and you're telling me you're getting the number one, arguably the number one defensive player on the line for the Texans, Jalen Carter? Hell yeah, let's go, dude. C.J. Stroud, Jalen Carter, sign me up. Hit me up with that Conor McGregor. Sign me up. I am absolutely all for this. Oh, man. I am definitely down bad for Todd McShay's updated mock draft right now. I am definitely down bad for it. I don't know if there's any other moves. I mean, day one, C.J. Stroud, Jalen Carter. Yeah. Hit me with the L.A. Knight. Yeah. I am signed up for this. Oh, my God, bro. This is amazing. This would be an amazing draft. Look, I get you losing a wide receiver in Jigba goes to the Ravens. You're not getting the wide receiver that you possibly want in JSN or Jordan Addison right here. But, man, to land Jalen Carter with a C.J. Stroud, boys, I am stupid stoked about this. Oh, my goodness. And Zay Flowers goes to the Giants. I don't know if we trade up again. And Saints, Eagles, Chiefs, and that's it, boys. That is it. Wow. What a day one draft the Houston Texans could have. Again, you get QB2 nationally ranked, QB2 and C.J. Stroud at pick 2. And then you get the best defensive player in this draft, arguably, in Jalen Carter. That would be a massive, massive day one for the Houston Texans. The draft party is going to be lit. Oh, man. That is it, boys. That is it. This is the mock draft right here. This is it. Todd McShay, buddy, you deserve it all tonight. You deserve it all. Oh, my goodness. You get Jalen Carter with C.J. Stroud. That gets me excited.
Daddy, chill.
That gets Texans fans excited. This is the mock draft to take a look at. And this is the prototype right here. You don't follow. If this does not happen for you, then obviously, it is what it is. If Jalen Carter is there at 12, which I don't think he will be, you take him immediately. You need this type of player on the defensive line. You get CJ Stroud, call it a day. We're shaking our hands. We are nodding our head up and down. Boys, the Texans will be back sooner or later if this mock draft comes to fruition. As always, guys, go Astros, go Rockets, go Texans. Y'all have a blessed day.